Good morning and welcome to our service for the third Sunday before Lent. Hidden God, we worship you. By ourselves we could not know you. No human wisdom can discover you. No argument lead to you. No enterprise reveal you. In the wealth of its knowledge, the world fails to find you. But you came to search for us. In the frailty of a human life, you trusted yourself to the fragile faith of wandering disciples. We praise you that in our very weakness we can know you, that stumbling blocks become stepping stones, and the foolishness of the cross, the very truth that quickens us to life.
Hidden God, we worship you.
And we turn to confession. We confess, O God, that we breathe the proud spirit of the world, the spirit which scorns the way of weakness, boasts of its cleverness, clings to knowledge as a means of power, and seeks to prove its worth by belittling others. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Hidden God, your wisdom unsettles our values and compels our love. Fill us with a desire to search for your truth, that being content to be fools for Christ's sake, we may transform the world. Give us eyes to see as you see, that we may follow your way of truth and righteousness. And the collect for the third Sunday before Lent. Almighty God, who can alone bring order to the unruly wills and passions of sinful humanity, give your people grace so to love what you command and to desire what you promise, that among all the major changes of this world, our hearts may surely there be fixed where true joys are to be found, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
grace of God has reached for me and pulled me from a raging sea, and I am safe on this solid ground. The Lord is my salvation. I will not fear when darkness falls. His strength will help me scale these walls. I'll see the dawn of the rising sun. The Lord is my salvation. His grace will renew these days. The Lord is my salvation.
New Testament reading is from 1 Corinthians. When I came to you, brothers and sisters, I did not come proclaiming the mystery of God to you in lofty words or wisdom, for I decided to know nothing among you except Jesus Christ and him crucified. I came to you in weakness and in fear and in much trembling. My speech and my proclamation were not with plausible words of wisdom, but with a demonstration of the Spirit and of the power, so that your faith might rest not on human wisdom, but on the power of God. Yet among the mature we do speak wisdom, though it is not a wisdom of this age or of the rulers of this age who are doomed to perish. But we speak God's wisdom, secret and hidden, which God decreed before the ages for our glory. None of the rulers of this age understood this, for if they had, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. But as it is written, what no eye has seen, nor ear heard, nor the human heart conceived, what God has prepared for those who love him. These things God has revealed to us through the Spirit. For the Spirit searches everything, even the depths of God. For what human being knows what is truly human, except the human spirit that is within? So also no one comprehends what is truly God's, except the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit that is from God, so that we may understand the gifts bestowed on us by God. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Be still, for the presence of the Lord, the Holy One, is here. Come bow before him now with reverence and fear.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
You are the salt of the earth, but if salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hidden. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have come not to abolish, but to fulfill. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth pass away, not one letter, not one stroke of a letter will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you, unless your righteousness exceeds that of the scribes and Pharisees, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Now I speak in the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Three friends went to see a holy man in the deserts of Egypt to ask about what they should do to live good and holy lives. The first one went in, and the wise man looked at him and said, "Do you remember the story of Abraham from the Old Testament? He lived a long way off the beaten track, and one day three strangers stopped at his door to ask for directions. He welcomed them in, gave them food and water, and offered them a bed for the night. You must follow Abraham and make people welcome and look after them and show kindness and hospitality. The second friend went in, and the holy man also looked him up and down. Do you know the story of Elisha? He loved to pray for others and spent a lot of time on his own, saying prayers for those in need, and God was with him. You must give time to prayer. Then the third friend went in, and the old man said to her, you know the story of King David. As a young man, he defeated the giant Goliath. He defended Israel against invaders and was anointed by the prophet as king. And he was one of the greatest kings. But there was something even greater about him. He was humble. He didn't think himself better than other people. He took the advice of his friends, and he knew he needed God's help, even when he got things wrong, or perhaps especially when he got things wrong. You must be a leader, but be a humble leader like King David. Always use your power and authority to help the poor and the weak. Use your life to make a difference. As the three friends began to walk back to the city along the desert road, they exchanged notes. So, what is the best way to live a good and holy life? Or to use the imagery in this morning's gospel, to be salt and light. They had expected each of them would be told the same thing, but they soon discovered they had each been given different advice that was a reflection of their own particular gifts and talents. The desert father discerned their own particular God-given abilities and encouraged them to use them to God's glory. As we reflect on what it means to be salt and light, we too should take a moment to reflect on God's calling in our lives. How might we be called to make a difference? And it is also worth remembering that the answer to this question may be different at different times in our lives. In my first parish, I came to know a lovely older lady through our contemplative prayer group. She shone with God's love. But when we sat and chatted over a cup of tea, she said she felt she was letting God down because she wasn't doing much to help people. In her earlier life, she had been like Abraham, hospitable, helping people, cooking cakes and taking them to the housebound. But now she needed help to see that her calling was more like Elisha's, to spend time in prayer for others each day. And she actually came to develop a rhythm of life with morning and evening prayer and intercession. She just needed to let go and be open to the new things God had in store for her at a new stage in her life. So we each need to ask God, at this point in my life, how can I be salt? How can I be light? Just as we are each different, so the answer to that question will be personal, unique, reflecting the people God has created each of us to be. But there are some commonalities about how our lives will be as we respond to God's call in our lives. One of the key things about salt is that it adds flavor to things. Our Christian faith should bring flavour to our lives and the lives of others. Sadly, being a Christian is often associated in people's minds with being a killjoy and going to church a bit miserable. The author Robert Louis Stevenson once wrote, "I have been to church today and am not depressed." It is a sad reflection that he felt the need to comment in this way about going to church. As we respond to God's call, we will find our lives naturally become more joyful, more flavoursome, and our worship, far from being depressing, is a chance to connect with God, who loves us and gives us life. Thinking about Jesus telling us that we are lights to the world is actually really encouraging and humbling. In John 9, Jesus says of himself, "I am the light of the world." And here in today's Gospel in Matthew, he is telling us to be like him. But there is something we can miss about this picture. The Jews of Jesus' time saw Jerusalem as a light to the Gentiles and spoke of a famous rabbi as a lamp of Israel. But they also knew that God lit Israel's light. We need to let God shine through our lives as we surrender to God's call. We would make a grave error by trying hard to be lights to the world in our own strength, no matter how well-intentioned we are. If we grin and bear it, trying always to be kind, always to forgive, and so on, trying to be lights without relying on God, then we literally burn out. The light dims, and we become empty and exhausted. There has been quite a lot in the press lately about burnout. What the image of being light tells us is that we need God to be always replenishing the fire in our hearts, the light in our lives, so that we can shine with his light. This means being humble and taking time out to pray, to be still, and to acknowledge that we can't do it all in our own strength. Some people find going on retreat helpful, and certainly we are blessed round here by being able to have a walk in nature as a way of taking time out to be with God, to reflect on his call and be replenished with his Spirit. So we are to be salt and we are to be light. What a challenge, but also what an amazing privilege. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Sovereign Lord, creator of heaven and earth and sea, and everything in them, we are your people. We give you thanks.
We praise your holy name.
You shake us and fill us with your spirit. You stretch out your hand to heal, to do signs and wonders through the name of Jesus. We are your people. We give you thanks. We praise your holy name. He is the author of life, handed over to be killed for us. You raised him from the dead and made us whole in him. We are your people. We give you thanks.
We praise your holy name.
Not many of us are wise by human standards. Not many of us influential. Not many of us noble birth. We are your people. We give you thanks.
We praise your holy name.
You choose the foolish to shame the wise. You choose the weak to shame the strong, the lowly and despised, so no one may boast before you. We are your people. We give you thanks.
We praise your holy name.
Your strength is made perfect in our weakness. Your grace is enough for us. We are your people. We give you thanks.
We praise your holy name.
And we say together the prayer which Jesus taught us. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Hidden God, we commend ourselves to your keeping and thank you for new strength given to us this morning. Grant that our hearts may continue in the peace and rest we have found in worshipping you. Through our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And we bow our heads for God's blessing. Go in peace, and may God himself, the God of peace, make you holy through and through, and keep you sound in spirit, soul, and body. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you, now and always. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed is the man who walks in your favor, who loves all your words and hides them like treasure. In the darkest place of his desperate heart, they are alive. Strong, sure light. Sometimes I call out your name, but I cannot find you. I look for your face, but you are not there. By my sorrows, Lord, lift me to you, lift me up to your side. Lord of eternity, Father of mercy, on my fainting soul. Keeper of all the stars, friend of the poorest heart, touch me and make me whole. If you are my defender, against me, no one can trouble or harm me. If you are my strength, all I ask, all I desire is to live in your house. Father of mercy, look on my fainting soul. Keeper of all the stars, friend of the poorest heart, touch me and touch me and make me whole.